Hello everybody, welcome to another edition of Designing for Fun on VIP Art Digital Channel. My name is Catalin and I'm a designer for fun. In today's video, I will show you how you can create fast and easy Scribble Scratch art designs in Photoshop. So without wasting any time, let's start working. Okay, welcome back to my computer. So without wasting any time, let's start working, shall we? So first things first, let's open a new project file. For today's video, I will work with 2000 by 2000, the width and the height, and for resolution 300. And let's click create. I already went to pixabay.com and download some images, two images that we're gonna have a test on. So let's take this turtle, for example, and let's drag it in. Okay, let's click okay. In order to create a quick selection around it, I will just use the quick selection tool. I'll just click and draw around our turtle. As you can see, the selection is not perfect. We did cut a lot inside the turtle. So what can we do? We can hold Alt or Option, click and draw inside the turtle to expand the selection. And in this way, we have our turtle nicely brought back. Check it out. Okay, almost finished. Let's bring this part back as well. Nice. Now, I do not care on having a perfect selection for today's video because we do not need for the effect that we want to create. With this selection already completed, we go to select and click inverse. We only want to select the turtle itself and hit Control Command plus J on a Mac. In this way, we cut the turtle out. But as you can see, we do have some liners that we want to get rid of. So hold Ctrl Command T to enter in that free transformation mode, Alt or Option, and scale it down a little bit. Here you can choose the eraser tool and just erase those extra lines that we do not need. Okay, now we only have this selected. On the top of it, let's create a new layer and let's hide this one. For this new layer, we're gonna choose a brush. Okay, so we're gonna choose a hard round brush. We're going to choose the size 2 pixels. Make sure that the foreground color is black. And what we want, we can draw something like this. Okay, so we're going to draw random lines. So first we're going to draw lines that are not connected with each other, at least not on the edge. So we're going to draw some, probably like this, 8 to 10 lines. When it's finished, create a new one. Let's hide this one. And this time let's give a more roundness to those lines. Again, very random, but again, more roundness to them. Again, between 6 to 8 lines should be perfect. Let's create a new one. And this time we're gonna make kind of like a combination. So I will go from creating kind of an X, give some roundness to them, okay? And go something like this. So I will only create like 3 or 4 brushes. Oops, we don't want to go outside the Canva. And let's create another one. This one I want to make it a little round towards the edge. Okay, so I can have something like this. Quite nice. As you can see, there are 4 different lines, 4 different random lines, and those they will be our brushes. So let's go to this one. Hold Ctrl Command to make a quick selection out of them by clicking on the thumbnail. Go to Edit. Here we're going to choose Define Brush Preset and let's call this Scribble 1. Okay. Ctrl Command D to deselect. Let's go to Layer 3. Open it. Hold Ctrl Command T. Hold Ctrl Command and click on the thumbnail. Make a quick selection. Edit. Define Brush Preset. Scribble 2. Okay, and we're gonna do the same for the others. Okay, hold Ctrl Command, click on the thumbnail, make a quick selection, edit, define brush preset, and here we can solve Scribble 3, and let's do the same for the last one. Scribble 4. Okay, now these 4 layers, we don't need them. We can select them by holding Shift and drag them to the trash. Now let's bring our turtle back. So select, deselect. What we want to do next, as you can see, my last layer, basically my last brush, is already selected, and that is really cool. But first, let's click on the mask. So we have an empty mask. Next, we're gonna switch the foreground color to black and hold Alt or Option and Delete to fill in the color. Now, when we have done so, our turtle disappeared. So let's lower this brush size a little bit by holding the left and the right bracket. Now let's click inside of it. As you can see, nothing happens. Why? Because we have black selected, so we need to switch to white in order to bring our image back to life. And now let's click. As you can see, we start bringing the turtle. So I'll just keep clicking, click, 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 click. And our turtle is coming nicely back to life. And as you can see for this, I'm only using one brush, nothing special so far. Well, let's go to the background. And here we have the black background selected, Alt or Option and Delete. And check it out, what do we have so far? It looks really cool. Check out the details, isn't it? Now, this one is a really nice technique if you want to create this type of stickers, and they will sell really nicely. Why? Because they are unique on the market, this style of designs. I want you to tell me how many of these Scribble designs are you able to find on Redbubble? I would love to hear from you. But as I said, this is quite a unique approach to do so. But let's say you don't want only to sell stickers, you want to create like unique phone cases. So because of that, we have kept the original file. On this file, we're going to apply the same strategy as we done before. So we're going to click on the mask, switch black background color, Alt or Option and Delete to fill it. Now we're going to choose the brush, white color, and let's click. But this time I don't want to go crazy with clicks. Okay, I will just click around the turtle to kind of have the idea where the turtle is. Next, I could switch to another brush. Let's go to the third one. And let's lower the size, maybe to like 100. If it's too small, I can only always use the right bracket to go above. As you can see, the blue lines will represent the water. So now we kind of have an idea where those things are. I can lower the brush and go around this area and add more details around the head. And the same around the flippers. Ooh, it started to look pretty nice. And again, I can change the brush. I can go for another one. Let's go for the first one, for example. Let's go to 200 pixels. Let's have a look. We can actually go higher than this, just to draw outside our Canva. So we kind of finished this, and check it out. It looks pretty cool. Well, we can always go back to our image by clicking on it. Let's go to adjustment layer and choose brightness and contrast. So here we can actually increase the brightness a little bit to have a better look on what's going on. Now, we can go back to our turtle layer mask, and this time we can choose another brush. We can choose a soft round brush. Okay, the standard one. And let's click outside. Oops. And let's decrease the size to maybe like 300 pixels. Perfect. Let me close these things. Now, the reason why I chosen this is, remember, our image does have some outline, some lines on the bottom. It doesn't cover the entire Canva. So this part, basically, we want to remove it. So how to do that? Well, choose black as a foreground color. And now let's blend those lines better with our Canva. Check it out. It looks pretty cool, isn't it? And again, as you saw, it's really fast and really easy to create this type of designs. It doesn't require no special skills whatsoever. Now let's try another design. As you can see, we can either have it for stickers, or we can apply it for phone cases, t-shirts. But now let's try to see another one, shall we? So let's take these ones, group them, and let's hide them. Let's bring another design. Okay, I took this one, for example. Let's bring it in. Let's make it darker a little bit by going to Image Adjustment, choose Levels. Okay, so I want to make the background a little darker, quite nice. I can make it brighter a little bit. Perfect. Well, at this point, I can just choose from normal, I can choose screen. So in this way, we remove the black and we can choose the eraser tool. Right click, actually not eraser tool. Let's click on the mask. We're gonna choose the brush tool. We're gonna have the soft round brush. We can choose a harder brush. And let's get rid of this. We have black color selected and let's remove those extra lines that we do not need. Okay. As you can see, it's really fast to remove the background in this situation. Now, let's see what can we do with this one, shall we? Well, first things first, let's take it, right click, convert to smart object. Why? Because I do want to keep to apply the layer mask that we have done before. On this one, again, we're gonna create a new layer mask, black color selected, auto option and delete. Select the brush and let's bring in the brushes that we had before by screwing all the way down. Let's start this time with Scribble 1, okay? And let's lower the size and let's see what do we have. Again, nothing will appear because we have black color selected as a foreground color. We need to switch it to white and let's see. Again, you can just easily fast click in order to add all the details really fast without wasting too much of your time. And check it out. Amazing, isn't it? And again, this is a really nice way, as I said, to create Scribble art design. But in our case, we do not have an interesting background. The background was initially black. So what can we do in order to have a nice background blanch for this one? Well, let's create a new layer beneath of it. Let's choose, again, the soft round. Oops. And let's choose some colors for it. Okay, so I will choose the brush, Alt or Option to pick a color, and let's start to draw in some background around it. I'm not sure how I will want it to look yet. I can sample the yellow color. I can go for the bluish. So far, nothing special. But again, I will click on the mask, select black color, let's choose the brush, scroll all the way down, I will choose number 4, and Alt or Option and delete to fill that with black, and let's bring in those colors, shall we? Switch to white and click. And check it out, it looks pretty cool. Oops, let me undo. I will bring it again. The brush is too large, so we need to lower the size. Okay, and let's see. Click, 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 click. Sometimes you may need to click more time in the same place in order to give more power to the brush. And check it out. If you don't like this brush, again, we can always go here, change the brush. Let's choose number 1, for example. And let's click again. I can lower the size, go somewhere around here. Okay, and now if we want, we can select this layer again, same as before. We can just go to Image, Brightness and Contrast. And you can increase their brightness and contrast and you're gonna get something like this. And check out the details. It looks pretty cool. And as you saw, really fast and very easy. So next week I'm planning to create a template that will automate the entire process. I'm still working on it in order to make it perfect. And once I succeed it, I will teach you how to do it and how you can convert all of your designs into a Scribble art design. Okay, so we already see how they look like this way, but how will they actually look on a t-shirt? So let's try to find out. So here I'll go to Redbubble and I will try to download the t-shirts from them. I'm not sure if I already have it downloaded them, not anymore. So I'll just go here and pick up a t-shirt. And check it out, this is how this one will look on this classic t-shirt. And it looks really good, isn't it? Quite amazing. And imagine if you actually start adding more details and some text inside of it using the same Scribble art style. Now let's see how will this one looks on a phone case. Check it out, looks pretty cool, isn't it? And it blends really well with the background. Let's see on a throw pillow. Wow, quite nice. Well, the same thing we can try with our turtle. And let's bring in this and let's see what we have. On a t-shirt, it looks awesome. On a phone case, it looks awesome. And again, if you don't want it this position on a phone case, you can always flip it around and you can increase the size of it and you can actually display it this way. And it covers a larger area and still looks pretty awesome. Let's see on a throw pillow. Pretty cool. Well, I hope you enjoyed the entire process, and if you did so, please click the like button to help a lot with the algorithm, and also leave a thumbs down in the comment section below if you are willing to give this a try and let me know how it worked out for you. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. A lot of amazing videos are waiting just for you. So until tomorrow, have a nice day. Bye bye.